What is up, my hungry gringos? How are you doing? Today we're gonna be talking about 5 essential pieces of kitchen equipment that I cannot live without, yet no one seems to talk about. Let's do it. If you like fun, funny videos that'll help you cook better, eat better, and live better, make sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you can get a notification every time I post a new video. So there's a ton of kitchen gear basics videos out there on YouTube that tell you to get a sharp knife, a really big cutting board, and some good mixing bowls, but that's not what we're gonna be talking about today. Today we're gonna be talking about some pieces of kitchen gear that I see myself using all the time, stuff that I cannot live without, but I barely see mentioned on YouTube. Make sure to watch the whole video because the last piece of gear that I talk about, I almost hear no one mention, but once I got it, it changed my kitchen life forever. And as a little bonus, it's pretty cheap. Kitchen essential number 1, a salt pig. Now I know Salt Pig sounds like a character from Mad Max Fury Road. I am Salt Pig, ruler of the wastes. Cower before my sodium. It's actually just a little bowl that you put salt in. And I know this seems like a weird thing to put in a kitchen essentials video, but this is literally my most used piece of kitchen equipment. And the reason for that is because literally every single dish I'm making, for the most part, has salt in it. And if that doesn't apply to you, well, now you know why people don't invite you to bring anything to the cookout. No, 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 your potato salad's great, Bob, but no, just head to the supermarket, get a dessert, bottle of wine. No, seriously, please. Don't cook. It's important because you want to have easy access to salt whenever you're cooking, and you also want to be able to reach in there and feel how much salt you're using. Salt shakers have you too far removed from the salting process, and on top of that, the crystals are usually really fine, so it's really easy to oversalt your dish. That's why you got to fill up your salt pig with kosher salt. If you look here, you can see it's got really big granules that are easy to pinch. But that's not the main reason you need a salt pig. The main reason is because it feels super cool to salt like this, you know? You're just like, woo, like a chef. Look at that, like a professional. I feel like I own a restaurant, but without the crippling debt and back pain. Get out of my kitchen. Yes, chef. Yes, chef. My mom got me this super fancy bowl thing, which is great because you can like open it with one hand and it kind of covers it automatically for you, but totally not necessary. You can just use a small little glass bowl or ceramic bowl like this one. I will say, even though this is relatively expensive for what it is, it's done me good. I've had it for years and it's pretty much like new. And don't worry, I'll leave links to all this gear down below in the description of the video. Kitchen equipment essential number 2, a pressure cooker. I don't know about you, but when a recipe says soak overnight, it might as well just say, hey, we all know you're too lazy to think this far ahead, so might as well just skip this recipe. Am I the only one who's this lazy? Leave me a comment below and let me know. And sadly, cooking one of the healthiest and most economical food items in the world always involves soaking overnight, but not anymore. Beans are amazing because they're a cheap source of protein and fiber, super filling, and according to Dan Buettner, who studies people who live to 100 years old in blue zones, as he calls them, all around the world, the secret to living a long and healthy life. So if you want to live long enough for new technology to be terrifying and frustrating, then you're going to have to eat some beans. Really? How do I reset my transdimensional whatchamacallit? How many times do I gotta tell you, Grandpa? It's a transdimensional demignifier. All you gotta do is reset the phase switcher. Back in my day, we only functioned in 3 dimensions and it was better. Why did I eat so many chickpeas? The future is horrible. I mean, living a long, healthy life, but you gotta soak something overnight and then boil it for 2 hours? Eh. I think I'll just die early. But if you have a pressure cooker, longtime kitchen staple of abuelitas all around the world, you can cook your beans in only a half hour. What a pressure cooker does is it raises the boiling temperature of water by putting it under pressure, which makes you able to cook foods way, way faster. And that's about all I know about the science behind it. I'm sure there's a video out there explaining it way, way better than I can. So no more extra soaking and no more extra sodium and canned taste from those canned beans. Sounded like an old-timey news reporter there. So say goodbye to soaking and sodium with the pressure cooker, marvel of modern engineering and design, sponsored by Lucky Strike Cigarettes. And as a bonus, you know all those recipes that call for low and slow cooking like stews or fall apart pork shoulder? Well, you can do those in like a quarter of the time in the pressure cooker. Me, I use it mostly for beans, but it's got tons of other uses that are awesome. You can also cook rice super fast in it if you're in a pinch, but you won't need to do that because you're about to get my kitchen basic number 3, a rice cooker. Excuse me, a rice cooker is cheating? I make all my rice on the stovetop. Well, tell that to the droves of abuelitas and Thai grandmas who use this every day to cook rice. Are you saying you know better than them? It sounds a little culturally insensitive to me. Wait, what do you mean culturally insensitive? Please. Don't tell anybody about this. They'll kick me out of my Harry Potter knitting circle, and you can't do that to me. I just got Slytherin. Typical Slytherin. Contrary to what a lot of people think, the stovetop is not the best way to cook rice. there's pretty much no advantage to using the stovetop over a rice cooker. You don't have to worry about the rice boiling over, or timing, or burning the rice, or anything like that. Just perfect rice every single time with one of these bad boys. If you need a good recipe for Cuban rice, check the link above. And don't think you gotta get a fancy rice cooker like this one. I got this as a wedding gift, but the Black & Decker super basic rice cooker I used to have did the job just fine. And sure, you can make a cake in this one, but after making that ketchup and mustard cake video, I don't think I wanna eat a cake ever again for the rest of my life. But yeah, with the rice cooker, just pop the rice on in there with some water, press a button, forget about it, and you'll have rice in about 40 minutes. Bonus, it will keep it warm for you if you forgot that it's done cooking. It's a magical device. Number four, the microplane. Now this is one where the utility is not immediately obvious, but it's something I use like all the time. The number one thing I use my microplane for is grating Parmesan cheese, because if you just gotta garnish something with a little bit of Parmesan cheese, why do you wanna bring out this giant box grater? It's too much of a pain in the butt. Also, the microplane has these fine little slivers that do a better job at certain tasks than the box grater. And as a bonus, the microplane doesn't have this weird side on it like the box grater does that's gonna ruin your sponge, and also function as a medieval torture device. Do you ever use this weird side of the grater, or are you just as confounded as me about it? Let me know in the comment section below. But Parmesan isn't all it's good for. You need to grate some ginger or some garlic, dissolve in a dressing, or if a recipe calls for either of those things, then just bust out your microplane. And if you need to zest a lemon or a lime or any form of citrus, boom, microplane. Bonus, I think it's only like 10 bucks online. I could be wrong about that, but I think that's what it was last time I checked, so no excuse not to get one of these guys. Equipment essential, number five. So this one is something I almost never see in those kitchen basics videos, and it kind of blows my mind because it's one of those things that you don't really think about getting, but once you have it, you're like, how did I live without this thing? I'm talking about the Cambro. What is a Cambro, you ask? Well, it sounds like a really annoying frat bro who insists on wearing woodland camouflage everywhere he goes. Dude, we're in a mall. You don't need to blend in with the foliage. But this is a Cambro. I know, that was one of the most underwhelming reveals in the history of the internet, but stick with me here. Now, the reason that the Cambro changed my life in the kitchen is because I found myself all the time making a large quantity of something that's very labor intensive, like, I don't know, chicken stock. And I don't wanna make it every single week, so I'll make a bunch of it and then have nowhere to put it. I'll put it in like random bowls and containers and all this stuff. But then I got one of these guys, and I didn't have to worry about putting my stock or whatever I was making in a bunch of different bowls and then taking up pretty much every container that I own inside my house. If you've ever been in a situation in the kitchen where you needed to put some stuff in a thingy, but the only thingy that you had was too small, maybe that's not the best way to phrase it. The storage container you had was too small, then this is something you should definitely add to your kitchen. Like this one time, my wife and I had a brine of turkey last minute for Thanksgiving. I know. I've come a long way, you guys. It wouldn't fit in the stock pot that we had, which was our biggest container. They were sold out of brine bags at Bed Bath & Beyond. And as we were heading home defeated, just so happened that my friend posted a picture on Facebook of them brining their turkey in their refrigerator drawer. So thanks to our Facebook hero, we were able to brine our turkey. While that makes for a fun story, it was pretty stressful and annoying in the moment. So if we had a Cambro, we wouldn't have to worry about that. I use this also for brining my cabbage when I'm making kimchi, and also fermenting the kimchi, because I don't want to put it in a bunch of containers around my house that will end up smelling like a sailor that just came back from trying to catch Moby Dick. Arr, kimchi. She's my probiotic-laden white whale. And kimchi and chicken stock is a huge pain in the butt, so I only want to do that like once a month. I don't want to have to be limited to making a small quantity of it just because I don't have the right size container. This bad boy solves all of those problems. Bonus tip, get one of these guys called a bouillon strainer when you're straining stock. It's way better than a fine mesh strainer or one of those strainers with the big holes and has the perfect shape for straining stock. This is what they use at fancy restaurants. This thing is awesome. And I know kitchen equipment is the only thing stopping you from cooking, so make sure to check out my other video where I give you some tips on how you can cook more often and save money by not eating out so much. I'm curious, what are your favorite pieces of kitchen equipment? What's that one piece of gear that you cannot live without that you don't hear anybody talking about? Also, show me your food pictures on Instagram. Tag me at TheHungryGringo or use the hashtag TheHungryGringo. And if you want to support The Hungry Gringo directly, make sure to head to patreon.com/TheHungryGringo. Make sure to like, subscribe, and until next time, this is The Hungry Gringo, signing off.